Let us now study about modulation of signals and carrier frequency. Here we can write, we already discussed, as discussed for effective signal transmission, high frequencies are much more effective and feasible over low frequencies. This is the reason, because at high frequency the antenna size is limited as well as the radiation power is high. So these are much more effective compared to low frequencies. Hence, we can write that for wireless transmission of signals, it is required to superimpose baseband signals, which are low frequencies, over the high frequency signal. This is called a carrier wave. It does not contain any information, but it is just a high frequency wave. And if baseband signal is superimposed on a high frequency wave, then antenna size required will be limited or practical, as well as the power will be decent. So here we can write, after superimposition, then this mixed signal can be transmitted efficiently. Here we can write that the superimposition of baseband signal with the carrier frequency, that is a high frequency wave, carrier frequency wave, is called modulation. Here we can write, if there is a device called a modulator, there is one input to the modulator is a baseband signal, and the other input which is given to the modulator is high frequency carrier wave. And when the carrier wave frequency is supplied and it is mixed with the baseband signal, the output is called modulated signal. And this modulated signal is the specified format signal which can be easily transmitted over the channel, which we have discussed in the section of elements of communication system, the previous topic before this we have taken up. So modulated signal is a high frequency signal with all information of baseband signal. At the other end, where receiver will receive this modulated signal, we extract the baseband signal from this high frequency signal, and the process we call demodulation, that will take up in the coming section.